The character Shan Fan used to be the same in Chinese pronunciation as San Umbrella, which appeared in every ancient China. When the king of Xuan was usually under an umbrella while out in procession, to indicate his readiness to recruit men of virtue as officials and to shade from the sun. Then, as the time went by, San and San categorized into two ways. San fan turning smaller. The original large fans used in processions graduated into some square, round and hexagonal compact fans, as they were generally used in the royal court. They were also called court fans. During the Northern and Southern dynasties in the 5th century AD. The Book of Southern Qi Dynasty had this. Chu Yuan blotted the sunshine with the Yao Fan, literally West Fan. This Yao Fan was the prototype of a present-day folding fan. It was not so popular at that time. Until Northern Song Dynasty, when there was manufacturing of fans in the marketplace, which means fans were at that time no longer for top-level people. At the end of the Ming Dynasty and the beginning of the Qing Dynasty, it became more popular among ordinary people and graduated into a style of elegance.
沿着上海的扇文化呢，因为这个改革开放以后呢，我们国运昌盛了，那么大家对文化的需求是要求越来越高了，那么所以呢，我们也参加了这些制作过程，特别是在文人的指点下，把这个扇子做得越来越精。我们家祖上呢，就是留下了一把扇子。
就是由我父亲的外公自己做，自己刻，自己写，自己画的这样一把陈扇。然后呢，我们家就一直有收藏扇子。扇子比较萧条的，那个大家都开始用电扇，用那个空调了。觉得扇子这个好像没什么用，那市场上不太好，然后各种原材料呢也都慢慢的缺失了。那我父亲呢？他特别喜欢扇子啊，翻了扇子书以后，他去找那些香妃竹啊、梅露竹啊这些，市场上都找不到这些原材料，然后他去找人讨教，然后翻阅了很多书籍，最后在有一本叫《族谱详录》的这本书呢，他很详细的记载了，就是所有我们国家所有的那个竹子各类花竹子啊，各种竹子的详细的产地，然后他进了山区。一点点找回来以后呢，自己调控的去做这个一点点把扇子做，设计成产品啊，再恢复到以前的这样的。这两年呢，扇子市场越来越好了。那么，我觉得在这方面呢，我父亲还是对那个这个扇子这个圈子这个行业还是挺有贡献。这个是我一步步看着这么走过来的，那当然也当中也很难，一个非常小众的一个文玩类的东西嘛。但是呢，它里面的东西呢，涉及到了有很多书画、雕刻，甚至说纸的制作，这都涉及到，包括连一个小小的钉它都有讲究。那你说真的玩起来又很深。但是如果说是像我爸刚涉及到这个行业的时候，这个工艺啊渐渐丢失的这样的一种状况呢，我心里很难受看的这种。然后如果说我想呢，有更多的人涉及到进来，然后把这个我们的传统手工艺啊一直维持着，甚至能做到更好。这个我觉得是非常重要的，是需要有人去做的一件事情。
我也听到了，所以呢，这次呢，我就把这把扇子带过来。
对，这个扇子要量一下尺寸。
我们家里收藏了一把老扇子。这把扇子呢是上个世纪，也算是名士吧。这瓶子当年得到了一把特别巨大尺寸的香妃竹，然后呢，他就命人做了非常大的扇子。做完以后呢，他就去找吴不凡，让吴不凡给他上面画画。这个传说呢一直没有实物考据。后来呢，大概在十年前，偶然机会，我们就在拍卖场上见到了狄平子写的书法的一个巨大的香妃扇。近两年呢，我知道新的香妃啊有新的材料出现，我们见到了小冯啊，冯其元。冯其元呢对扇子很有热情，而且他也跟我说过，哎，有什么特别好玩的东西，我们来做一点，做一个当代可以传世的东西。所以呢，我们就开始寻找料子，我们就开始要准备做一把当代的香妃巨扇。
To make an exquisite fan, the lines of the fan profile are very important. The simpler the design is, the more uncontrollable the making is. The key point of determining the fan profile is the corresponding effect of the lens of the major ribs and their top and bottom breadth. During the old times, without designing systems, the creating process.With the sense of lining was an accumulation of experiences workmanship. They were masterpieces. These amazing artworks have gradually become standards and references for later generations. In face of modern urbanization, as natural resources are in short supply, each piece of bamboo material needs to be cherished.Raw materials need to be air-dried or sun-cured. And not every piece of bamboo can eventually be the suitable material for fans.
We went to Anji. Anji is a Zhang Wu Zhen, is a very traditional, history of the fan.以前它主要供货呢，供给杭州做杭扇，然后现在呢，全国性的都大多数都统一在那边，那边的制作工艺呢，还是在国内属于比较先进的。它无论从打磨技术啊也好，开料技术也好，那边都有得天独厚的一个优势啊，在那个安吉本身是有一个大族。
Anji was named after peace and auspice in the Book of Songs.Which was the birthplace of the ancient state of Yue. The mountains and rivers there nurtured the splendid culture and humanities there. In particular, Zhangwu County sees a major river flowing through from southwest to northeast, presenting a scene of a river in the middle with mountains on both sides. The modern art master Wu Changshuo.Was just born here. He commanded in his old age with a poem, Wildness in the mist of clouds, valleys in the songs of streams. This town of bamboo, surrounded by green mountains, is the birthplace of Zhejiang fan culture.
说实话，最近忙吗？
还行，最近天热。
是热。
Bamboo is a tall and fast-growing grass plant, with a stem of wood. Chinese people revere it for its fearlessness of adversity and bitterness, hollow and upright, embodying the virtue of never bending perseverance.It is seen as a spiritual wealth and aesthetic value, particular with the bamboo. The well-known poet Su Dongpo once said, I would rather eat without meat than live without bamboo. It shows that the hard-to-bend bamboo is hard to cut for material, which demands the cutting skills of the fan-making masters.Who would often make repeated comparisons on the mold in order to cut out the most beautiful patterns from the bamboo.
做这把扇子呢，是当初是就是因为是头一把，他手里面数据呢，只能根据数据呢，先用机雕去做一个模，然后呢才能上架，然后把那个就是多余的那个部分是用通过模具来去掉，这是我们拍摄当中看到的。大鼓的难点最重要的是那个弧度，那个扇子呢是一定是整体的，是一个纺锤形的，这一点很重要。现在做扇子呢，很多人不讲究，他就是做的笔笔直，然后号称单手开合，这个是错误。涉及到大鼓的外观选择，外观选择呢，就是我们选的啊，花好看，对吧？然后底色干净。整体造型的话呢，一般来说是，两片大鼓是合在一起做的，不太会有什么问题。你只要掌握好是，笔直，就是中线是笔直的，那就可以。那你有模具或者没模具，这个都可以保证。一定要紧。那下面扇钉部分呢，又是一个收，然后做成这样的纺锤形呢，就是保证下端没有保护的这段扇面呢，尽量的寿命延长。最主要的也是最讲究的，一定有要求的，就是那个纺锤形的这个这样的一个弧度的造型要做出来。所以说做扇子这个纺锤形的这个弧度是最重要的。那你不仅要有弧度，然后贴合小骨合起来以后呢，它又要相对来说严丝合缝，那就是这个弧度每一个细节啊，那个每一个角度你都要有很好的掌握，才能贴合好。
The Yuefu Folk Poetry Collection has it. The folded fan lying on bed, the mind expecting the wind. Li Shi in Song Dynasty also has it. The fan come upside down, knocks down the red fragment slice. Serenade of a peaceful joy.Enjoy the cool by the pond also has it. Lying on the bamboo mat after drinking, enjoying the breeze brought by the fan. As you can see, this tiny fan embodies so many letters and lyrics of elegance by scholars. These smooth and silky imaginations come from the careful and thorough polishing.
小孔呢，那有在以前呢和现在的区别呢，就是长烧和短烧，那有一部分做的比较在扇面里面的这烧的这一部分呢，有的做短的，有的做长的，那相对来说越长不要顶到扇面顶端的是最好的，但是这样相对来说难度也高。然后小骨呢直是最基本的那个要求嘛，然后厚薄均匀啊，每一片小骨的厚都是要有一致的。
The rib-to-rib orderliness and opening degree are also important. The making of an exquisite set of minor ribs needs to experience a multitude of procedures from rough cutting, tailoring, polishing to sticking. Usually, the density of bamboo is around 1.5, equivalent to that of an adult bone.But the bamboo tendon is quite fragile. Therefore, in rough cutting, you will need to meet the veins of the bamboo and to make the breadth and the thickness even. Not only taking into account whether the ribs are all the same in length and breadth after they take shape, but also reservation of some flexibility space for tailoring and polishing.In order to make a flawless set of minor ribs, the fan maker needs to be thoughtful at the very beginning. The rough cutting, tailoring, and polishing all need to be just right. Overthickness would affect the opening degree and hand strands while in use, and underthickness would shorten the lifespan of the fan. In the making of the minor ribs, the key procedure is called sticking.The sticking skills are usually what the fan makers are competing about.
合青就是由两个半片小骨的青面粘合在一起。 对胶呢又同时要有要求，那胶呢不能是完全硬的胶，那要有半软的那些弹性胶。还有一个问题就是你这个竹子竹片薄了以后你上了胶，它呢胶里面有水分，会导致那个竹子的那个就是弯曲，我们叫卷啊，那个它会有轻微的变形。那么你做的同时呢，你要涉及到你还要计算好它那个变形的那个变量，哎，这个是一个经验性的事情，就是说你要把变量算好，然后两片加胶合起来以后呢，第一不能漏胶，第二个你加胶合起来以后呢，变成一个四方的竹片，那是要正好的，而不能有什么卷起来这种状况产生，合清呢也是比较难的啊。大鼓小鼓合在一起考虑的其实就是现在我们讲究的就是一个严丝合缝，严丝合缝合在一起呢，就是我们很简单的有的时候竖起来看一看，然后就是当中看不到有缝，然后也整齐，最重要的我一直讲究的就是一定要有加力，加力要足，加力足它才能保证扇面的使用的时间更长啊，那个市面上所说的那些单手开合呢，是其实是并不是很好的，它把吃力吃在扇面的下端，容易造成扇面破损。
Shape blending is the last step of fan making. It is to bind the finished major and minor ribs together, planing, polishing, trimming.To accomplishing the entire artwork, it involves repeated disassembling and assembling very carefully, refined with each rib, to achieve an effect of being both good looking and flexible in the right way. This tedious bitterness in the eyes of an outsider is just the happiest moment for the fan maker. Bamboo fragrance in the air, stillness of the outside world.Only the solo dance of the planner on the rib, accompanied by the sandpaper. The fan maker puts into free rendition his rhythms from the bottom of his heart. Sounds like the music by string and pipe ensemble. Rhythmic and elegant, with the pleasure of killing time floating in the air.
这个过去有一种讲法，认为我们的折扇呢，是从朝鲜啊高丽这个传到我们，从明代传到我们国家来的。实际上情况并不是这样。在多年之前呢，我曾经在常州博物馆看到了一件元代南宋的漆器。上面就有人物手里拿了折扇，所以可见这个折扇的发明啊，应该也是我们老祖宗的一种智慧的一种表现。搬作一次千叠类呀，这个搬作也是竹子里面非常华贵的一种，所以这个他这把扇子啊。我当时看了以后感到上面就是朵朵的梅花，我这是想我们这是从远看的角度讲呢，就像是一片莲塘的荷叶，对吧？所以我跟他一起构思在上面还画了小鸟画了小鱼，对吧？这样就产生了一个这个荷塘这样一个意趣，
来，我们灌河啊，
Zheng De and the Jia Jing period in Ming Dynasty saw the birth of Jia Jing bamboo carving art with deep carving and multi-layer cutting as its major characteristics. Afterwards, there appeared a group of special craft masters. They were both scholars and craftsmen. Their carvings were usually smooth and gliding with a profound philosophy but clear purpose. The scholar's touch was the combination of bamboo carvings and fan ribs was thus growing up in this soil.
正反两面经过韩老师的精心构思和精湛的笔墨使得画面更加生动。那么我呢用刀来把韩老师的那个笔墨情趣尽量的能够表现出来。因为竹刻是文人所开创的一门技艺，它必须要有文人和画家的参与，才会赋予竹子艺术的品味。
表面做好清理工作就漂亮。
哎，对的。
As early as the middle of the 10th century, Chinese calligraphy and painting art boomed in the south. To witness a situation of draw between the north and the south about some 800 years later, the freehand painting style in the south gradually stepped onto the stage of Chinese art history. Folded fan techniques, meanwhile, enjoyed full development in this context.Blending poetry, calligraphy, and painting on the fan to have developed the unique folded fan culture.
In the process, I was very excited. 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 I was very excited.能把它复刻出来，非常激动。这么大材料，但是一开始是试想着先做几把，然后最后找了在上千片料里面找，竟然只找到这么一对，而且还是稍微有点缺憾。然后再经过这样做成扇子以后呢，再经过巧雕去把它补足，这个设想都融合在里面。做的过程当中，制作过程当中是非常非常兴奋的。
这把扇子我们花了12分钟的努力，从选材到制作，到配扇面，到扇骨上的加工，到扇面上的书写。而这把扇子出现了以后，我们就感觉非常惊叹。最初它只是一个数据，我们要去模仿一把低平子的巨扇，但是在制作之后，我们就发现。这把扇子真的不容易啊，是师傅没有碰到过的一个尺寸，在所有的加工工具上都碰到了难点，但是最后我们都把它克服了。所以我认为这把扇子啊，有钱人而无后来的一把扇子应该是非常非常棒的。
On the historical stage of Chinese art and design,There appeared many categories of excellent forms of art and design, although many of them have faded out with the advancement of industry era. There are always such a group of art preservationists who are preserving on and off this perseverance by generation after generation has brought before us the spirit of our ancestors in art.Among them, there is no lack of young art preservationists who are further developing traditions in current social soil. These crafts of art, thanks to their perseverance, have never gone beyond people's horizons or out of people's life.
其实这个我们一个做一个制扇工作的从业人员来说，制扇子制好了以后通过我们的书画能够使我们达到一定的要求，这个扇子呢已经达到当今是最好的水平了，可以如果说再配上名人的字画，应该说是达到当今制扇艺术的比较高的一个水准了吧。
冯老师的这把扇骨也是做得很精致啊，然后那个 韩老师也是他那个画的构图也是很那个有那个独到的构思，之所以那个有了好的扇子跟好的画，那么跟我一起结合，所以我刚才说这把扇子就是有了艺术的价值。
我认为是有了这件作品啊，这个让我在那个扇子文化当中啊，有这么一点点，有我这个参与的这一部分，非常非常荣幸。也谢谢各位老师啊，那个配合的帮我们把这件作品完成了，谢谢。
一个山砍的小花，配色配得很好，大小骨配色配得很好。做的时候，小骨是合青的，它合的时候一点缝都没有。
这个
工艺完全达到贵族的工艺。有韩老师提的字，这张扇面也是特为了韩老师而定制的。通过韩老师的认可，这样扇面也是
整体效果还是挺好的，红花的凹凸的。